Okay, now I think I am audible to you now.
Yes, sir.
Okay, sorry for that delay. Okay, we'll just wait for another 2-3 minutes so that others can join. What happened in yesterday's meeting with the HOD?
He told us to attend the class regularly.
But what about
and he asked
whether
we are facing any problems.
But a few students are there are telling okay, some network problem is there. What about a solution for them?
He didn't told any particular solutions.
Okay, because I think almost more than 20 are unable to attend the classes.
Yes, sir.
What should be done for them? Any suggestions, solutions for them?
No, sir. He told just try to attend the class. That's it.
Okay, fine. Shall I start?
Hello, sir. Good morning, sir.
Yeah, good morning, ma'am.
Sir, if the question is explain divergence and curl, should we write the definition only or the entire derivation for a vector operator into A is equal to 0? Like this, we should derive or just the definition?
Can you repeat the question?
Sir, if the question is like explain divergence and curl, which was this year question, 2019 it came.
Yeah. So just write only a physics part. No need to write mathematical part. I have done no in the notes.
Only the definition. No, only the definition. That's it. Or we should derive that P is a point where in the dV is the volume which is surrounded by the point charge and derive it. Should we do like that or only definition?
If they ask only what is divergence, okay, correct, no? The question is divergence.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so they will ask divergence, whatever I taught you, know, divergence of physical meaning, that is enough.
Okay.
Divergence and physical significance, similarly, curl and its physical significance. So, like that,
so it's physical
significance? Yeah, physical significance they will ask.
Okay, sir.
Okay, that's what, because we are not dealing entirely in the mathematical part. So we need what is the physical, physical significance of that. Therefore, you just go through the notes. I think I have clearly explained to you.
But yes, sir, physical significance.
Yeah, that is what is important here actually. Definition, significance.
Now that positive divergence, negative
divergence. Correct. Positive, negative divergence and definition.
Zero divergence.
Correct. That is enough.
Okay. So that part for where it was there in the notes also, that derivation part, how you have derived the entire divergence of A vector into.
Yeah, this, actually, it is not derived, it is a definition actually, it is not derivation, it is a definition.
That is the definition only.
Correct, yeah. That
it was written as definition only in notes, yes, a definition.
Yeah, no derivation, only that much is enough.
That we should write all that things.
Yeah, correct. That only you have to write.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
If they ask significance, then you have to write the other part also, significance part. Okay. Today, I think this is the last part of this Maxwell equation. Let me complete this. Welcome back again. So, in the last class, you learned what is Ampere's law. If you remember, that Ampere's law, is what is called curl H is equal to J. This is again Ampere's law in differential form. The basic Ampere's law is integral H dot dl is equal to I. Correct? No. Right? So what there Ampere's law gives? So if there is a conductor, okay, which carries current, assume current is flowing. So then, as you know, okay, around this conductor there will be a magnetic field in the form of circular loop. Right, this is how the magnetic field will be there. Then according to Ampere's law, how much magnetic field will be there? So around any circular loop is given by integral H dot dl is equal to I, where I is what is the current. Okay, the current flowing in this conductor I. Okay, and the same Ampere's law, so in differential form, so is given by curl H is equal to J. So where J is the current density and H, as you know, it's the magnetic field. Okay. Now, let us see what is this modification or modified Ampere's law. So again, purely it is a mathematical concept. So you just take divergence of this Ampere's law. That is del dot del cross H is equal to divergent J, because I'm taking just divergence on either side. And in mathematics, you know, so divergence of curl, remember, is a curl actually, curl H. So divergence of curl is always equal to zero. This you are going to prove in mathematics. Therefore, this LHS side will be equal to zero. Okay, this side. Therefore, what you left is no divergent J is equal to zero. So this is just to take Ampere's law and take curl on either side. If you take curl on either side, so you are going to get divergent J is equal to zero. That is again from Ampere's law only. But now you just recollect what is from continuity equation. So from continuity equation, so you know divergent J is equal to minus del rho by del t. Okay. Now if you just see this, these two equation, if you just see here, so there is some contradictory thing is there. So Ampere's law tells it is giving the divergent J is equal to zero, but continuity equation tells that divergence J is minus dou rho by del t. So remember, rho is what is the charge density. Okay, so that shows that, so there is some problem or something wrong or some incompleteness is there in the Ampere's law. This is actually, remember, Ampere's law. So Ampere's law is not complete, or some modification has to be done to Ampere's law. This is what Maxwell tried to explain. So because of these two contradictory things from Ampere's law, so Maxwell stated that, or Maxwell explained that, so Ampere's law is incomplete and is applicable only for a steady field, it is constant field. Whereas for a time varying means alternating, AC, some correction has to be applied and used some correction like this. Okay. So what correction he applied? So remember, this curl H is equal to J is Ampere's law. So no Ampere, so he applied, so this correction to Ampere law, I mean Maxwell. This correction term, so JD dash. Just see this stop. So this is Ampere's law. Since there was some contradictory thinking, now what Maxwell did, he modified Ampere's law by introducing a term called JD dash. Anybody, do you remember what is JD dash? Is Bhavan and Spurti are there in the class or not?
Displacement.
What is JD dash? Yes? Somebody? Can you respond to this question? What is JD dash? Remember, J is the current density. What is JD dash? We derived last class by taking capacitor example. You remember? Yes, I'm audible. Hello.
Yes, it is audible.
Yeah, what is JD dash? Can you tell what this term? So J for current density. Remember, D for displacement current density. This will come in capacitor. No, we last class you just remember, right? Took, yes, capacitor, sir, example. Correct. No. So no, yes, Ampere, I mean Maxwell, he incorporated the displacement current density term here. So that's why I derived in the last class only what is displacement current. Okay. So because of this incompleteness in the Ampere law, so Maxwell, he said that so some correction has to be applied. So and that correction term is what is displacement current. Now let us see once again. Let us take curl. So as you took curl here, no, I mean divergent here, no. Now you take divergent for this corrected Ampere law. This is called corrected Ampere law. So now once again you take again divergence. So divergent of curl H is equal to divergent J plus divergent J D dash. As I told already, divergent of curl is always zero. Therefore, again R LHS is zero. No, but R H is no divergent J plus divergent J D dash. Okay, but again according to continued equation, divergent J is minus dou rho by dou t. Now you substitute that. So therefore, you will get minus dou rho by dou t is equal to, I mean plus del of J D dash is equal to zero. Okay. So, but from Maxwell first equation, you remember divergent D is equal to rho. Okay, therefore, wherever rho is there, now I'm going to substitute this. Therefore, minus del by del T of divergent D plus divergent J D dash is equal to zero. Or what is divergent J D dash? It is rho by, I mean, del by del T of divergent D. Okay, now. So, now, or divergent del T by del T. So on either side you have divergent here. So this implies J D dash. Now I can write simply equal to dou D by dou T. D is called electric displacement. So this is what we are going to get. So after applying corrections to Ampere law and after taking divergence. Okay. So after taking divergence, so we are going to end up with an expression for current density, displacement current density given by del D by del T. Now substitute this JD dash here. You substitute that JD dash here. Okay, so what now it becomes? So your Ampere's law now becomes curl H is equal to J plus delta D by delta T. So this is what is called modified Ampere's law. Okay, so this is just Ampere law up to here. So after the correction term, so one more term will come in Ampere's law, that is delta D by delta T. So now after this modification, your Ampere law becomes curl H is equal to J plus delta D by delta T. This is in terms of H. If you want to write the same expression in terms of magnetic induction capital B, remember B is equal to mu naught into H. Okay, so therefore the same Ampere law in terms of magnetic induction becomes curl B is equal to mu naught times same J plus delta D by delta T. Now this equation is what is called Maxwell's fourth equation. Ampere. This is Ampere corrected law, correct? It's not just Ampere law, Ampere's corrected law. So that we are going to call as Maxwell's fourth equation. Okay, so if they asked you to derive Maxwell's fourth equation, so you have to start from here only. So start from Ampere's law. Okay, just show that Ampere's law is not complete. Then you apply this correction term. Okay. So then, so we are going to get a formula for the current density, displacement current density, that you substitute back. Okay. Substitute back here. Then you will get curl H is equal to J plus delta D by delta T. So that becomes modified Ampere's law. And it is also known as Maxwell's fourth equation. So this is what I derived all the equations. Just to recap you, So remember, what is Maxwell's first equation? Divergent D is equal to rho, or divergent E is equal to rho by epsilon naught, because epsilon naught into E is capital D. This is a Maxwell's first equation, it is derived. Similarly, Maxwell's second equation is what? Divergent B is equal to 0, or divergent H is equal to 0, both are same. Next, Maxwell's third equation is curl E is equal to minus delta B by delta T. And last one is curl H is J plus delta D by delta T. So these are the four Maxwell's equations. So and you must practice the derivation part. Okay. Now, let us see what is the role or what is significance of these equations. Okay, because so much of mathematics is there. So you may ask, sir, what is the role or why we ought to study or what is the significance of this? Okay. So you remember the Newton's laws, no? Newton's laws of motion. You remember? There are four laws are there. V is equal to U plus AT. S is equal to ut plus half at square, v square minus u square, yes, equal to 2as, correct? No, those are correct.
Yes.
Newton's laws. Similarly, you have laws in thermodynamics also. Remember the laws of thermodynamics. So the three laws are there. First law, second law, and third law. Even there is one more law called zeroth law also there. Thermodynamics laws. Okay. So in motion or in mechanics, so Newton's laws are there. In thermodynamics, okay, you have thermodynamic laws are there. Similarly, in electrodynamics, so this is mechanics, this is thermodynamics. In electrodynamics, so Maxwell's equations play the same role as Newton's laws in mechanics and so the laws of thermodynamics in thermodynamics. Okay. Now let us understand in depth what is the meaning of that. Well, I think you will appreciate if you understand the significance here. Just let us see the first Maxwell's law. Divergent D is equal to rho. Remember, actually, this is nothing but Gauss law only. We started Gauss law and we converted Gauss law into this form. Okay. Now what is significance of this? Remember, rho is a charge density and divergent D means electric field, because D is equal to E, divergent D. So what it signifies is, understand this sentence, a charge distribution generates a steady electric field. So what is charge distribution? See, rho represents what? Charge distribution, no. So rho is charge density. Remember. And according to this equation, a charge distribution, that is a rho, okay, generates a steady electric field. This is divergent, no? What is divergent? Flux lines, correct? Divergence means how many flux lines are going out. So it means a charge distribution rho will produce what is a steady electric field. That is the significance. Or meaning or understand from. So this Maxwell's first equation. Are you able to follow? The charge distribution means rho.
Yes, sir.
Generates an electric field. This here, capital E is here, electric field. Okay. And that electric field depends on the charge density. That means greater the rho, greater is the value of electric. That is the significance of first law. Just remember, first law is nothing but actually Gauss law only. And what is the significance of that? So a charge distribution rho generates an electric field. And that strength of the electric field depends on the charge distribution. Okay, similarly, so let us see what is the second law significance. So remember, second law means divergent B is equal to zero. So what it signifies, it says that in magnetism, monopoles doesn't exist. Or divergent of magnetic flux lines is always equal to zero. Because you remember, So in case of magnetic field, okay, so there is always what is a north pole and a south pole here, no, correct? And magnetic line starts from north pole and ends at south pole, correct? And if you take any closed surface here, okay, if you take a closed surface here, then the number of magnetic lines entering is equal to number of magnetic lines leaving. Therefore, there is no divergence, or divergent B is equal to zero. Right? So that is a significance. Same thing I've written here, it signifies that magnetic monopole doesn't exist. That means equal number of lines of magnetic induction enter, it is entering, and equal number of magnetic lines leave the surface. That is significance of the Maxwell's second equation. Now coming back to the third equation. So curl E is equal to minus dou B by dou T. So remember, curl means rotating. Okay. So actually it is, we derived this equation from Lenz law. I mean from Faraday's law and Lenz law. So therefore Maxwell's third equation is nothing but Faraday's and Lenz law only, okay. And what it signifies, see, it states that electric field, that is capital E, can be generated by a varying magnetic field. What is varying here? Understand here what is dou B by dou T means. The rate of change of magnetic field, no? Correct? That means whenever magnetic field changes, change means with respect to time, what is going to generate? It is going to generate an electric field, the CL. That's what is written. An electric field can be generated by time-varying magnetic field. And this is the principle used to generate electricity in dynamos, power plants. Okay. So, by varying the magnetic field, they will generate electricity. Okay, followed now? The significance of third equation. Okay, yes, remember, sir. It is actually, we derived this from Faraday's law only. Okay, now coming back to the last one, what we just derived. So what the last equation? Curl H is equal to J plus delta D by delta T. It's also nothing but Ampere's law only. Okay, are the same. A curl H, instead of H, if you write B, then becomes mu naught. Remember, mu naught is permeability of free space. So, same, J plus delta D by delta T. Both are same. Here, in terms of H, I will turn. Here, in terms of B, higher order. Okay. So, as I told, so this basically represents Ampere law. So, what it signifies, though, it gives the relation between, let's see, it gives the relation between B, it is magnetic induction and current density. So this is the relation. And what it signifies? It represents, or it states that magnetic field B can be generated from J. That means if there is a current density is there, then it will generate a magnetic field. Whether the current is steady or it is changing with time, in both the cases it will generate magnetic field. So just see here, magnetic field can be generated from J and the time variation of D. D means current density again, jointly or independently. That means even if this is not there, remember this is actually the AC part. Even a steady, this is means J means steady. Even a steady current can generate magnetic field, or even a time varying current can also generate a magnetic field. So that is the significance of Maxwell's fourth equation. Okay. So let me repeat again. So Maxwell's fourth equation is nothing but Ampere's law. Okay. What is significance? It relates the relation between the magnetic field and current. Okay, and according to this, So if there is steady current, it will generate magnetic field. Or if there is AC current also there, then also it represents magnetic field. Okay. So just to recap, so basically these Maxwell's equations relates the relation between the field and the charge, and the magnetic field and electric field and the current and magnetic field. How they are related. So this complete the theory part. Please enter your names in our USN in the chat box. So would you have any questions or shall I go for problems? The problems are not started. Just I will share one more thing. Just wait. Can you see the new share? Is it visible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, problems. So these are very simple problems. So let me take the first problem. So determine the constant C such that the vector, some vector is given. So here x plus 2y, y plus 5z, x minus, here you can see some C is there. So that it is solenoid. That means if vector A is to be solenoid, then what is the value of C? So remember, what is solenoid? So any vector A or B or anything, if it has to be coiled as solenoidal vector, its divergence should be equal to zero. What is if curl is zero? If curl of a vector is zero, it is called irrotational vector. Curl A is equal to zero. If divergence is zero, it is called solenoidal. So now I will apply that. So if divergent A is equal to zero, just take divergent. You know what is divergent? Divergence means del by del x of A, del by del y of A, and del by del z of A. You just write only the x component here, x component, y, z component here. Just I'm substituting here the x component, y component, z component here. Can you see here? It is substituted here. Then take the remember the partial differentiation. It is not total. Only with respect to x, you will differentiate. If you differentiate with respect to x, you get 1 here. What about 2y differentiation? This will be 0, no? Similarly, if you differentiate this with respect to y partially, you will get 1 and this will be 0, yz. Similarly, here it is 0 minus c into 1. One plus one minus c into one, or two minus c is equal to zero, or c is equal to two. That means if you substitute two here, then the divergent A will be equal to zero. That means A is solenoid. It is truly a mathematical problem. You followed no first problem?
Yes, sir.
I think somebody has to mute their audio. Similarly, now take what is the example for irrotation. Here again, a vector A is given 3x squared plus y plus az and bx minus 5, something like that. For what value of A, B, C? So you need to find the value of what value of A, B, and C. The given vector is irrotational. This is what irrotation. So remember, again, definition of irrotational, for any vector to be called irrotational, its curl should be equal to zero. And also, the curl of a vector is given by some disturbance. Please unmute. Curl means Determinant form is there, no? What is curl? Determinant form you write, definition, okay. And wherever ax, ay, az, you write the components. This is the ax component, x component, y component, just substitute there. Okay, x component, y component, z component. And you know how to expand determinant, no? Do you remember how to expand determinant?
Yes.
Yeah, ax cap, okay. So del by del y of this, correct? This?
Yes, sir.
Similarly, minus del by del z of this. Next, minus ay. Again, if you take ay, del by del x of these two, no? So take these two, correct? Then del by del z of this. Next, plus az of del by del x of. So del by del x of this. And del by del y of this. This expand determinant, that's all. So then you take the partial differentiation. Remember the partial always. Okay. So if you differentiate this, what you will get? 2x plus cy. So you will get 0 plus c into 1. No. Can you see here? Similarly, what about here? If you differentiate this partially. 0, 0 minus 2 into 1. And minus into minus plus. Okay. So just do it, will come, not a problem. Then you simplify, you'll get c plus 2 ax, something like that. Now this should be equal to 0. So this implies if I put c is equal to minus 2, then this will be 0. And if I put a is equal to plus 2, this will be 0. And if I put b is equal to 1, this will be 0. That means if I put c is equal to minus 2, a is equal to 2, and b is equal to 1, this whole thing will be equal to 0. That means the curl will be equal to 0. That means a is irrotational. Okay, similarly, let us see next problem. This is a different one. Determine the total charge within a volume. So volume is given, 10 raised to minus 14 meter cube at some point. So what is the meaning of this? Here, okay, some volume is here, okay, and net volume is given. And point, this is the point P, okay, somewhere they have marked some point here in this volume. So, in this volume, P, the value of x, y, z are given 1, minus 2, and 3. Here, x is 1, y is minus 2, and z is 3. And here, capital D means flux density is given. The value of capital D. So you need to find how much charge is there, okay, at this point, right? And for this you have to use Maxwell's first equation. Remember what is Maxwell's first equation? Divergent D is equal to rho. Rho is called charge density, and that is given by charge density means what? Charge per volume, no? dq by dv. So this also you have to remember. Okay, so first find only the divergent. Remember, divergence means del by del x, del by del y, and del by del z. Okay, so substitute d is given here, substitute the components here. Okay, then take the partial differentiations. Okay, so and now here you have to put the value of x, y, z. It's what to x, y, z. After divergent, you put the value of x, y, z. You are going to get divergent D is equal to some 24. Okay. Now you have to find the charge. So again, use divergent D is equal to rho. That is dq by dv. So this implies what? dq is equal to divergent of dv. Okay. That's what I have done. Divergent of dv. And divergent is 24. Into what is dv? Volume is given as minus 14. Okay. So this is the total charge. I mean charge at that point. I think the diagram is eraser. Okay. Followed? No. So I am applying just the Maxwell's first equation, divergent d. But remember divergent definition also. What is divergent definition? And rho definition, rho is dq by d. Similarly, next problem is prove that vector field is ruling order. So what you have to do? You just take divergent of this. To show that divergent A is equal to 0, it is ruling order. It is same as first problem. You just try to work out yourself. So similarly, one more. Electric flux density is given. Find charge. Same thing. Divergent D is equal to rho. First find divergent. Definition of divergent. Then you substitute the x, y, z. You will get divergent value. Then rho value. But here directly they asked you to find only the charge density. No need to find charge. So only rho. Okay. Similarly, this is what last semester paper. Find the divergence. So they ask only divergence. Okay. They are not asked you to verify it is solenoid or not. Yes, divergence. Remember definition of divergence. Okay. So here you have tried only x component, y component, and z component. Yes. But take partial differentiation. Don't take total differentiation. Okay. Let's see. And then you put the value of x, y, z, 136. So this is 246. Similarly, again, only you have to find curl of a vector. Okay. Remember curl definition, determinant form. You substitute the components of x, y, z, expand the determinant, then substitute the value of x, y, z is given here. This is purely a mathematical type of problems. No need to worry that much. But still some 7 or 5 has not entered their roll number in chart box. Please enter. Only 2 minutes is there. Yeah, I hope you're able to follow at least something. This completes the second chapter of module 3. So one more small topic is this. It is electromagnetic waves. I think it will require another 2 classes. So by Wednesday or Thursday, I will complete module 3 also. And be prepared for a quiz on Saturday. Okay, only on module 3. It is optical fiber, first chapter, and Maxwell equation, second chapter. Okay, are you able to download the notes, no? Whatever I'm sending in Google Class.
Yes, sir.
I think you cannot take print because the printer shops are not there. If you have a printer, okay, you just take hard copies also. Anyway, this Saturday, be ready for a quiz. It is just like an objective type of questions. Okay, some 20 questions will be there with three or four choices. Just you need to select which is the right answer. Okay. So be prepared for that. What about any other problems? Actually, yesterday I tried with Google Meet also. In Google Meet, this annotations will not come. Correct? So wherever I want to do some exercise, something like typing or underlying, that is not possible in, I think, Google Meet. Correct, no?
Yes, sir.
I think this is only is what do you call as user friendly, I think, because whenever or wherever I need, I think I can draw something and highlight, and that option is not there in Google Meet. Therefore, I will prefer only this. Yesterday, I tried Google Meet. I think Zoom is better because some issues are there with Zoom also. But anyway, because we are not dealing with any security issues, no, not worry. Only the class. Are you aware of that? Zoom security issues?
Yes, sir.
Because it is from China. The Chinese government can encrypt some issues are there. Let us not worry. Anyway, fine. We'll meet day after tomorrow because tomorrow is holiday. We'll meet on Wednesday. Fine.